from Scooter HQ, and today we'll be introducing you to two new bikes on the Australian market today, both from Derby, the GP1 50 Racing Edition, as well as the Derby GP1 250 Racing. GP1 50 Racing has some unique features to it. Upside down Marzocchi forks, connected to a radially mounted AJP racing caliper, 14-inch alloy front wheel, as well as a 14-inch alloy rear wheel. Big aluminium dual beam frame provides excellent stability, rigidity, low centre of gravity and handling. Unusually for a scooter, Derby in the GP150 Racing have mounted the engine up front, where in most scooters they're mounted at the rear of the bike. This provides excellent weight distribution. In the GP150, Derby have centrally mounted the engine in the frame. Putting the weight in the centre of the bike provides the bike with excellent weight distribution. This allows Derby to use a conventional aluminium box section rear swing arm and monoshock rear suspension. Today we're taking you through one of the most exciting bikes to hit the Australian scooter market in years, the Derby GP1250. The GP1250 represents a great leap forward in technology for scooters, and we'll take you through and show you exactly what I mean. Starting at the beginning, you have a 14-inch front alloy wheel which is connected to upside-down Marzocchi forks and AJP Racing radially mounted brake calipers, which are a first for scooters. Moving back, you have an alloy perimeter frame, which is, the technology from this is directly derived from Derby's GP1 125cc racing experience. Moving back, you have the Piaggio source Quasar 250cc engine, which is fuel injected, four valve and liquid cooled. Finishing off the rear of the bike, we have twin Ole shock absorbers, 13-inch rear aluminium wheel, again with AJP Racing caliper on the rear disc. GP1 storage is actually quite good for a 250cc sports scooter. Fitted with a glove box, which is nice and recessed and deep, so when you put something in there and you open the door, it doesn't fall out. It also has two wet compartments, we call them, which means that they're not particularly dry if it rains, but good for keeping things like keys and MP3 player. Under the seat, which is opened off the ignition, you have a full-size seat bucket capable of taking just about every helmet on the market. With the helmets, we recommend that you try it before you buy it. Also under the seat is the 11.5-litre fuel tank, which runs a 2-litre reserve. Instrumentation on the GP1 is digital and analogue. You have a rather large analogue tachometer to count your revs. Your digital display shows your speed, clock, odometer, a trip meter, and also when you hit reserve, it starts another display which tells you how many kilometres that you've travelled since hitting reserve. It also has another little feature which, when you start the bike up, tells you how many kilometres you've got to go till your next service. Switch gear control is the obligatory electric start, kill switch, indicate left and right, push to cancel, horn, high beam switch, as well as a little passing light which flashes your light when you need to overtake a car. Headlights on the GP1, as you can see, are a twin headlight arrangement. They're both independent and have their own globes in them. You have a low beam, easy switch to high beam, and as well as that, you have a little passing button which flashes your lights at anybody that you need to pass and let them know that you're on your way through. Now that you've had a little look at the GP1, it's time to take it for a ride.